This is one of the final moments of the film where I have decided to come back for my son. After walking in the desert for days, I change my mind at the last second and I drive back to Vegas, and this is me arriving on the street where he is, where he's staying, and coming up to all this apocalypse. And that's my car in real life. They didn't have to do too much to it because it was already really messy.
And then the cops came, and on one of our, the guys that's working with me, Stu Gallagher was the only person on the street, and the cops came and they stopped, and they were just like about to brandish the gun. What the hell are you think you're doing?
By that point, there was like more busted cars and like blood and shit everywhere.
We just said, we were like, fuck it, we wanted to like walk it out, whatever.
Hey dude, so what's going on with the cops right now? What happened? How's it escalated?
They pulled up. They were...
Who did?
The first cop pulled up. I got out of the car. I was standing down there. He asked me what the hell was going on. I didn't really have an answer for him because I didn't want to incriminate anyone or myself. So I told him to talk to the producer, and then I ran for my life.
When the first cop showed up, like I was like, oh my god, we're getting shut down. We've got half the street set up. Brittany! Go to the back of the street. We'll start shooting now.
Come over this way.
They dragged their feet and were like, no, you can't have a permit to shoot in any of the desert anywhere. So we were shooting it anyways, and we went and stole every location in the film.
We had permission from no one.
I think this is a really special film because it gives people something definitely that they have never seen before. There's really good scary horror throughout it, which is great for audiences that crave that.
Trying!
Nick! Nick, it's empty! It's empty!
And slightly to the right, he's coming closer.
Oh my god.
And run to Nick.
Nick!
That was nice. Cut.
Cut. Cut. Don't make those motherfuckers as bad as they say on the news, right?
Yeah.
If he wasn't dead, he sure as hell is now.
Looking
at the same spot. Ruin, it feels like you're looking a little bit wider. So, where are you looking, Britt?
I'm looking at the tip of Juan's head.
Okay, look at the other tip of Juan's head then, Ruin.
Yeah.
That's a nice shot.
What's going on in the scene?
Well, this is an ominous kind of...
This guy pulled into the sand and, you know...
Oh, I pulled into the sand.
Yes.
My character pulled into the sand because this one here needed to throw me.
Yeah. Justifiably.
Listen, don't date sex workers or coke addicts.
Well, I don't know if that's true across the board, but...
Okay, I want to hold the position. I fucking love that take. I want Merwin to get into the car.
Because I'm a very visual person and I like to really see the shot and know the frame, but in the desert you just point a camera everywhere and everything kind of looks the same in all directions. And so, you know, in scouting the film, we checked out a lot of different places and it was very difficult to pick, okay, this place will be this scene right here.
Right. Basically shattered my mind, which is that when you're thinking about like, oh, we'll shoot in a house, you're like, okay, so we'll be in this corner of the house here, that'll be cool because the staircase will be in the background or whatever, and then we'll flip around. In the desert, you're like,
Right. Yeah.
Where do we set the scenes?
The lesson learned during, like, scouting the locations was, like, let's set the scene right next to the road.
That was awesome.
So that no one has to walk very far.
Yes, this is a blood rig for the zombie biting a chunk of the rapist's neck out. So this is a Hudson sprayer that's plumbed with blood. And as you can see, it's got a hose that goes all the way up our actor's back to his neck.
Yeah.
So when the zombie bites the muscle, rips a chunk of flesh out, blood's gonna pour out. This is where the blood is right now, here. And for me to get it to go up to there, I have to pump and press the trigger here.
From just like right in this.
And then blood will pour out.
2, 3, action!
Tear at it! Eye out. Clean his eye out, please.
Did we get it?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck
you.
Yeah.
That's you.
That was wild. That I kind of used as inspiration for a lot of his physicality. But the other thing that I feel like I've tapped into is Smalls' childlike nature. He's just like basically like a baby in a lot of his mannerisms. Because of the virus that's taken over, he's lost his faculties. But what's happened is it's put him in touch with this sort of, yeah, this really childlike innocence, which is cool. And I think that's what will help the audience connect to this character.
Kind of thing. Yeah. No, it's wider. Medium wide.
Okay.
And action.
Then we shot at these dunes that are great, but unfortunately Nellis Air Force Base is right next to those dunes.
More, please.
There's more.
No, that's going with you guys. The other bag is the one that you search for. Yeah, let's go again though. I love it. I thought it was awesome. Let's get a better one.
Put some sand in my mouth. Ate some sick. Got some sand in my ear. It's Monday morning. Friday night we finished. Lying in a pile of cactuses in below freezing temperatures in this little getup. Because it's supposed to be the desert. It's supposed to be really hot.
Even in the conversation, checking out the road, worried about the road, worried there's gonna be some fucking zombie apocalypse shit up ahead of you.
No, we got him on. We're just gonna trim him with it. We got enough of you guys listening.
This is D camera, scene 3, take 5, Mark.
At first, actually, the script was written with a man. It was a one man and one zombie in the desert. And then they let it sit for a little while and they came back to it and they realized, oh, so we're actually better as a woman. And then they kind of wrote the role with me in mind. So that was, you know, really, really special. And I think it gave me a really, like, personal connection to the material well in advance of us shooting this.
I know that I haven't been around a lot lately, but I'm coming back, okay?
I'm so sorry, I'm here.
Okay, listen, I'm leaving right now. I'll be there soon.
But then ultimately it's got this deep heart that I think is a
a well-executed and honest and touching story of a woman who's, you know, who's coming to terms with herself and with her actions and her life. So I think it will touch the audience in many ways and hopefully give them a really good scare and leave them feeling empowered and you know, inspired by this woman who ultimately comes out ahead.